friends are here, and your boy has been invited to the party. That's right. They think that they need some more interesting ways to introduce this to other people. So guess what, alien fans? I'm going to be on your screen.
I'm all up on your screen. What you going to do about it?
Not a goddamn thing. You're going to watch because it's the UAP report. And Craig, if you come in, I will stop it and we will do this. But just know now, you have some questions to answer before. Anyway. All right, here we are, into the good stuff. Woo, can't wait. Love you, UFOs, oh my God, oh my God. All right, so people, you do a lot of deep thinking on this, and then you say, where did all these alien reports or UFO reports come from over the decades? Let me see a map, what that looks like. Here you go. And this tells you things. You will immediately make assumptions, because I did. Watch that little state up. Watch that little country up there on the top left. It's gonna be important. Oh no! It's
lighting up.
Those are all the sightings from the 1940s. Now.
Wow.
Huh? Huh?
I just said wow. That's crazy.
Getting brighter. And look in Europe where it is. England and America. Interesting. Mm-hmm. All right, folks. Let's think about this. All right. Let's think about this. This is from a verified website. This is proper information. And what you see is where you see alien sightings or UFO sightings are where the highest air superiority in the world is, as far as aircraft, as far as United States and England. They have the highest Lockheed Martin, Skunk Works, Boeing. Why do they coincide with UFO? Doesn't this kind of open your mind to some ideas? Like, oh, maybe they're just all military craft, or oh, maybe the aliens are working with one group only. And these other dots around the thing are where those other groups are.
Huh?
So it's a plot on the map. This is where these things are seen. Look at the country that's lit up. Are we just crazy? Or are we chosen? Or do we live in a place that has this geographically?
Something that they want, maybe.
I want you to, for 1 second, peruse Egypt. Not one light. This thing goes deeper and weirder than we can imagine, is the point. Egypt gets none. Saudi Arabia gets none. All of Asia and Russia, none. America, like every night.
Crazy.
I think it tells a story about us, our mythology, what we believe in. We're storytellers here. We tell each other stories.
Mm-hmm.
All of those lights are real. But here's the thing. There's a million lights you're looking at right now on the screen. One. All it takes. Starting to look like the population center's density, not the UFO. This is very interesting information. Don't see a lot of the Rockies. Don't see any over the Great Lakes. See very few over the Pacific coast, in the water. These are in the cities. Remember, no other country looks like this for their sightings. Just us. So just a bit of information to store in the old noggin. Because what I'm trying to do with this series at the UAP Rapport is once it's all put together in like a 2-hour thing is to just give you opinions bouncing around. What is this? I don't know. Is it real? I don't know. I'm a demon. I don't know if UFOs are real. We don't know down there. We're as curious as you. We were created here. Our God, our devil, our Earth God and Earth devils. Who are these freaks? That's what we want to know. Hey, you remember that time that a bunch of, or two alien ships appeared on a live NFL broadcast? Wasn't that fun? Let's watch.
I want you to explain that to me, Dr. Fox.
I'm afraid to. This is sort of a Twilight Zone football game. Those were some kind of, I don't know what they were. Pittsburgh?
I don't know either. This is where the rivers come together, but I didn't know about that. What are those things flying around up there?
Well, they're just some kind of a illusion.
I hope we get another look at them.
If you ever do get a coaching job, though, I'd like to be hired just to bed check and do things that are important around the training facility.
You'd be my first employee.
There it is. Now, what is that? You keep saying, take us to your leader. I don't know.
Yes. This is before drones. Like 30 years before drones.
Now, that's another.
What is that, DJ?
The guy I'm going to hire, whoever's responsible for
no
that. Stay tuned as the NFL Today continues after this word from your local station.
They even used it as the background. They use it as the background on their lead out. They're like, hey, look, aliens, fun. Dallas is up 7. Like, we're humans are fucking weird. All right, everyone, you know, we all know Grush. I got the Grush crush. All of us alien people have the Grush crush because this is a band that came out as a whistleblower and said, there is an alien craft retrieval program in the United States government. Here is where they are. Here is who pays for it. Here is who is involved. Thanks, Congress. And everyone's like, what just happened? That happened. So let's watch him with one of my least favorite men, but a man, you know, whatever. I probably shouldn't even said that. We don't do politics here. We like people that ask questions. So this man asks questions, we like him. There we go. Yeah, we're staying out of it. UFOs could take
me home. A cover up.
Account for the behavior you're describing.
Yeah, at first.
They're hiding something real that implicates them. And if they're talking to these entities, whatever they are, and I believe on the basis of evidence that the U.S. government has made contact and has had continuous or at least sporadic, but over a period of years contact, you don't need to nod or shake your head. But that is my belief based on talking to people. Like, what is that?
Yeah, if there's certainly, you know, a relationship that was cultivated with non-human intelligences, hypothetically, I guess, you know, to play off of what you just said, good or bad, it's almost like we were afraid after 9/11, dirty bombs, terrorists. Okay, well, that's nature. That's life. Yin and yang of the universe. If there's malevolent non-human intelligences, okay, well, that's a fact of life. Don't hide it because what if the U.S. populace needs to be prepared for something somehow?
Well, of
hypothetically.
Course. And it's also not their right to hide it because they don't own the government. The public does, actually.
Exactly. And it's just, I understand the reasons at first, but like you said, I think it's just the moral decay and the decay in leadership. And once again, well, we don't want to admit we did all this stuff years
ago. But also, if the U.S. government has had contact with these entities, and again, it is my informed belief that the U.S. government has had contact, what are they talking about? What is that?
Hey, I would like to know too.
So what I got from that is there is a giant secret that everyone knows behind the scenes. A lot of media people know it. A lot of senators know it. And I will pose this. Disclosure is guaranteed by 2027. We are going to have visitors to this planet in ships in 2027? Do they come from the middle of the earth? I don't know. Do they come from a long ways? I don't know. But 2027 seems to be the year that everyone is talking about. So
why 2027?
It seems to be because we need to get... There's 5 billion, 6 billion people on this planet. It's impossible to get them agree on anything. And so if you tell them all, oh, aliens are coming tomorrow, this whole planet will burn down. So the NHIs know that. The non-human intelligences understand us better than we do. Mm. So they're in charge of disclosure, not us. They're telling us when to do this and when to do this, if it's happening. This is not the human government controlling it. No, this is NHI controlling it. And so NHI is saying, do this, do this, do this. Now, we all know Men in Black. We all know Independence Day. We've all been conditioned. The conditioning will continue for generations. There's already, I didn't pull it, but there's already a Super Bowl ad made by Martin Scorsese with aliens, and it looks very real, and it's sort of like Don't Look Up, where we don't really care because we're looking at our phones. So they've created a condition. The NHI have created a condition on this planet where we don't care when they come because we're focused on, did you see the canned fart this lady put in the can? And so we're not paying attention. And so, but they will be here. This is a certainty, people. 100%. So we need to ask ourselves, where are we now with all of this? Let's refocus. UFOs could take me home.
The way I think about that bucket, in my opinion, I've seen enough evidence inside the anomalous bucket to consider that there is another, you know, entity, a consciousness. There is something there that is other, you know, but the format, where it comes from, right? Like, that's the big question. And, you know, sufficiently advanced technology could make things seem like it's interdimensional when it's very much not. Or faster than light travel could make aliens also time travelers, right? Because if they're moving faster than the speed of light. So things, I think, are going to get messier before they get clearer, but that's because we're going to start really uncovering stuff and be able to figure out some things that aren't just buried in our imaginations or our assumptions, but based on reality, which is often much weirder than what we can imagine.
Yes, I think that last point. Think about your imaginations and think about reality. It's often much weirder reality. So why wouldn't it be weirder? So I just think that was a collective, where are we now, right? Are we, what we have learned, where we have come, and what is next? Because again, it's such a big secret. And we don't know what the secret is.
Mm-hmm.
And the secret might be so shocking that you don't want to go on tomorrow. None of us, 5 billion people all decide, no, we're not going on. Or it might be so big that once it's known by all of us, the NHI go, oh, lab, experiment over, kill the sample, and then we go away. Because we don't know what we are. But if we learn what we are, affect what we actually become. And this is something that, you know, we all need to think about when we think about disclosure. There's a reason that we've had to evolve to this point to even have these discussions. Because when we were eating each other, NHI would be like, no, not quite ready yet. Right? We're probably still not ready, but technology might be forcing the issue. AI might force the issue. UFOs could take me. All right, this is a famous Art Bell call. If you don't know who Art Bell is, he hosts a show. He hosted a show. Okay, in Nevada, and it's in a secluded Nevadan desert compound where he takes these calls. There's a few of them that have now been called legitimate by the U.S. government or parts of it. This is one that was called legitimate by parts of the government that could come forward and say yes. And it's a man describing how he found a place, found an alien creature, and then was scared by it, but then went in and found it again and recorded some sounds it made. Sounds fabulous, I know, but keep in mind, in this era, the technology, we didn't have smartphones, so we had recorders and tape recorders. We were weird.
I felt like I had to try to document this.
Of course.
So I took my camera, and I took the recorder, and I turned it on.
And that's a picture of the creature that he found. He called it a cross between a gray and a lizard person.
And I, again, freeze it, and that's when I record.
And it was... I forget the beginning of the story, but somehow he put it in a freezer and then he opened it up as it was dying. And this was what the sounds.
The sound.
Would you play the sound for us once again, please?
Yes, I will.
No, that's not the sound.
Hold on.
So I'm a music producer. I've heard a lot of screams. Never heard a human scream like that.
My God, that's awful.
And it's in a time where you would hear the tape. Like if they like tried to fuck with the tape of the sound of the sample, you'd hear it. That was whatever in that room made that sound. So it was either, who's in the '80s? Give me a butt rocker. I'm lacking butt rockers, right? It was Axl Rose. It was Axl Rose in the room, or was it an alien? Here we go. And you need. Oh no, I didn't label this. Okay, I didn't label that one right. Anyway, this one is. This one involves the Ariel Zimbabwe sighting back in the 1970s. Children in a school in Zimbabwe, Africa, many of them saw between 1 and 4 creatures with big eyes, dressed in black, exiting a craft and approaching them. At this point, a lot of the kids ran because, oh my God, wouldn't you? But some of them stayed because they didn't believe what they were seeing. And as the creatures approached, they had a telepathic message. It was communicated to the children about an environmental disaster that was about to happen to the world and how they could help. And before returning to the craft and flying away, this is all they told the children. Now, they've come back to these children 20, 30 years later, and they have the same stories. They're not liars, because they live in poverty. They didn't make any money off of it. And so this is one of the girls describing what it was like to get the telepathic communication from one of the aliens. This is called the Ariel sighting, and it has not been debunked in the 30 years. There's been over 10 witnesses, children, and over 20 staff that heard the story when the children came in. So, if this was in an American court of law, guilty. Enough evidence. Well, let's see.
It was maybe the world's going to end. Maybe they're telling us the world's going to end.
Why do you think they might want us to be scared?
Because we don't look after the planet and the area properly.
Mm-hmm. And is this an idea that you have had before, that we don't look after the planet properly in the air? Or did this idea come to you when you had this experience?
When I had this experience.
Mm-hmm. And how did that idea come to you from this experience? This is a little hard, but try to be with me here, okay? How did this idea come to you when you had this experience?
I just felt all horrible inside.
You felt horrible. At what point did you feel that? When you saw the craft, or when you got home at night? Or
when I got home.
You had that horrible feeling when you got home.
Yes.
And to say more about that horrible feeling, Lisa, what was it like?
It was like in the world, all the trees will just go down and there will be no air and people will be dying.
Mm-hmm. And those thoughts came to you, had you had those thoughts before this experience?
No.
And
they have a same interview with her 20 years later. And she is as firm as she was this day as a child. It's amazing. So it's either mass psychosis, someone drugged the kids, or it happened.
How did those thoughts come to you? Did they come to you from the craft or from...
From the man.
The man. And the man, did the man say those things to you? How did he get that across to you?
Well, he never said anything. It's just that the face is the eyes.
What was the sense you got from those eyes?
He was interested.
Not scared. She's not scared. She says that he was interested. That's interesting.
Not lying either. Many body experts from... All right, folks. That's where we are. We are in a golden era of UAP and what's going on. And hopefully we'll get some sort of disclosure. Because wouldn't you like to spend, you know, the last 20, 30 years of your life, if you're a Gen Xer like me, living in some fucking weird world we saw in a movie when we were a kid? Oh, please give it to me.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be amazing. I'd love it. I don't need the same thing I've seen the last 40 years. I've seen it. It's time, folks. You know what time for?
Shut your ass up, bitch.
Time to shut up, and it's signing time. So, get your phone out, get over to the keyboard, and this is like, would ya, for UFOs. Are these real? Are these fake? It's signing time, people! UFOs could take me
home. Tap it. I'm sorry.
What is that?
There's a passenger on the plane. Looks out the window. Grabs the phone. This was filmed in June. The traveler sees that, an object apparently changing shapes in seconds.
What?
Oh. Is it a shape-shifting object? Is it Bezos? Is it Branson? What is it? Is it a UFO?
Mel, go for it. What do you see?
Okay, I'm looking at this for the first time. I want it to be surprised. Whoa!
What was that?
You're flying out your plane and you see that happening out your window. What? What matrix are we in?
No way.
Okay.
Oh, that's crazy.
So French
fry. Yes, so people, a one in the chat, you think that's real? Or two of you think it's fake on the first one. I'm good. Hold on. Got to put my number in there. Hold on. There we go. Number one. Yes. That's a number one. To me, that's real. What the fuck? That ain't like something falling. What is that? That's changing shapes. And the thing, here's my qualification for real. If it's a fourth dimensional object, it's going to be weird looking to us. It's going to change shape and we're not going to understand it. Just like a third dimensional object would look weird in a two dimensional space. That is what that is. Just weird to us. Like, what is that? But if it's fourth dimensional, we're not going to see the whole thing. We're just seeing the reflection of the thing. So yes, number one on that one. So it's from Canada News. Does that mean something bad? I don't know. Yeah.
UFOs could take
Here we go, chat. This one blew my mind. This is from an aircraft. This is over 30,000 feet. What is sitting on top of the clouds?
An emoji.
Wait till the zoom. What is that? That is not a natural cloud formation. You have hard angles, created angles. Look at all the clouds around it, and then look at the created ship that is hiding in the clouds. Why are you hiding better aliens is my question. Jesus Christ, we have smartphones now. It's 30,000 feet in the air. It looks like an aircraft carrier in the clouds. Right, it's a Voyager. It is. It's an Enterprise ship. No, I'm sure that's just some fog. Or, you know, like some smog. Nothing to see here.
With hard angles. Yeah, all the time.
There's a picture of it. It's Noah's Ark in the sky, baby! We're not alone! But here's the thing. We're not alone, but they let all the people that you love die. So they're not our friends either. We're food! You know, my message has always been we're food. And when I got the message from the group that wanted me to join, they're like, we like your message. Now I'm thinking, oh no, it's the food message they like. All right, this is the video that Tom DeLonge showed Joe Rogan of one of the back-engineered aircraft. So this is a Skunk Works back-engineered TR-3B. Yes, and we have this technology, but not the technology to cure cancer. So fuck us, right? Here we go. gone. So, if that's real, that's the technology that we back engineered and that we're talking about. Hold on, let me put a one in the chat. That's right. Always real. Just remember, all it takes is one. And then we're talking alien. Or ant. Alright, this was filmed in Iraq. And again, good luck faking these with the fucking, how they look. I put it through my editor. I didn't see any fake lines around it. And if you watch, you watch the little lights underneath it. That's what gives it away as real. People, it's happening. It's happening around us. It's time to wake up to it. Just accept it. We're gonna have a fun last 30 years. Maybe more. Maybe they'll give us eternal life. Who knows? UFOs could take me home. Hold on, let me put a one in the chat. Put a one. UFOs could take me home. All right, this one was filmed, 14 years ago. But look, again, can't fake these ones. They just released yesterday a note at the National, Office of Videos or whatever. We're going to release all the UFO. So watch Twitter, because they're going to release a lot of old videos. You're going to see like grainy lines from the 1920s. This is how disclosure works. We're going to show you the ones from the 20s and the 30s. So long ago. Yeah. But they're still here. They've been here before us. They'll be here after us. But again, another one of these TR-3Bs, maybe, one of the early ones. And I've heard a scientist talk about why would they make them dark? And it's hard to hide the chemical reactions that go inside of them, so that's why you can't make them dark. Like, you can't hide a exploding star. It's just too much energy that creates photons, which is light. And light is impossible to... Hold on, let me put a one in the chat.
I like seeing the old ones, actually, the old footage, because they didn't have the technology back then to make it up.
No, and our eyes immediately recognize the hidden valley of new technology making that old stuff look like it's old. And so, yes, some of the greatest films are from, like, Oregon in the 50s, and then you're like, what? But the other thing is, like, the UFOs look old. I don't know if that makes sense. The UFOs look as old as the pictures. So it's almost like we think that these UFOs are thousands of years ahead of us, so all that, but they might evolve too. They might have evolved with us. They might have been the first ones out of the ant cave, and they look like little tin cans. Who knows? We know! All right, Wilson. Now this one is from, I think, Uruguay or Paraguay. And it has never been debunked. And if you look at the shadowing on this in the time, 1988, this is one of the greatest UFO videos that has ever existed. Until 2024. Goes behind. This is technology not able to even fake with Steven Spielberg back then. And this was hidden from the U.S. government. Well, for the public. Government probably had it.
What kind of camera did they have? Jeez.
It was just a, 1988 Fujifilm Sony camera. Like a normal camera.
Oh, that thing's really low.
It is very low, and it is very real. Some of them... Yeah. How do you deny all this? Only one has to be real. UFOs could take me. Hold on, let's put one in the chat. People, it's always a one. All right. Now we get to some controversial stuff. Is this a live alien? Is this a live alien?
Okay.
This is on his security camera. Blink. Head twitch. Subtle movements. Blink. Head twitch. Subtle movement. Mouth movement and quick exit.
Huh.
Now, I've done some puppetry. That's a very expensive puppet. That's a $2,000 puppet. Would you like to see some of it again? It happens fast. UFOs could take me home. And this man said he was stalked for a while by aliens and all that stuff. So, you know, take that for a grain of salt. But I'm telling you, watch the blink and watch the mouth. Watch the mouth. There's just a little mouth moving at the end. I don't think you can make up. Anyway.
It looks like it's kind of like watery, like the skin is moving like water almost.
Yeah. Like it's not made of carbon, maybe another molecule. Like we're carbon-based creatures.
Mm-hmm.
What if it's a nitrogen-based creature or a helium-based creature? Yes. Oh, we're so nerdy right now. Here we go.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we're down to 11 people. Oh my God. Oh, here we go. I don't care, by the way. Thank you guys for being with us. You are the shit, and we love you for it. Thank you. Here I am, looking for that. Thank you for sticking with us. Now, this was filmed during the Iraq War. Again, another one that was just released. It's all happening, baby. Oh, what was that? What's that right there on the top right? But that's not the big one. There's the mothership! Oh no! Bigger than an F-16. These are F-16s. Again, look at the decoloration and the shading, impossible to recreate. And watch all the lights. You start to see the lights around. What they call Foo Fighters. See it right there? The first light. So, what they called the Foo Fighters in World War II were the bright white orbs that were around the craft. They were like, these craft must be German, but these Foo Fighters, what are they? Because they're like lights. Watch, these like lights. The light. Group of lights all around it. What are those? And then, the mothership. There's another light. Another light. More lights. Oh, look at those lights. Mothership. And so if you have someone who is Air Force or Navy, then they probably run into these things in the combat zone.
I do. Twice my cousin is Special Forces.
Yeah, so
in the Air Force. Geez.
Because these things seem to like to watch what they do up there. They don't interfere too much. They just like to watch. Which I don't know. It seems a little more discerning that they have the power just to watch. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Oh, it's so interesting. Hold on, let me put that was clearly real. Oh, I think I got a 2 for you. Yeah. Because no one's going to believe it until this video comes out. That's what it's gonna take. Yes! Goddamn ants! Oh, wasn't that fun?
So what about the ants?
Oh, this was a light on the ants. This is more for maybe they're from... We have to examine all the options. They might be ant people. They might be from there. Who knows? But I'll tell you this. Oh, it's going to be a fun last 30 years. No, that's going to be very fun. Oh, and please, this just actually came out. I just got this. So I told you I joined this group, right? And this group, they hooked videos ahead of time. This is one they just sent me. This is from Sweden two nights ago. Two nights ago from Sweden. This is what they filmed. Yes. 2-5. Three nights ago.
Really?
What is that? That's Jetsons. I don't see no wings. What is that? And that looks clearly filmed. Look how it's... You can tell.
It looks like a drone.
It does look like a drone, but we haven't been shown the drones without wings. It's like a UFO without... But it is flying straight, so it's not like doing any weird... Yeah. Oh, what was that one? Hold on, I'm gonna... where's the chat? That one? I'm gonna put a 1.5. I'm not sure. But that one just came out, so I wanted... So I am in this group now. I should be getting even more advanced imagery coming up. So please, if you love the UAP, subscribe, become a member. I just got an exclusive invite to a private party that has a lot of information on this. Or they're just fucking me and gonna fuck us all with disinformation. Either way, content. Hold on, Big Willy Style texted me. He canceled on me. All right, Big Willy, good job. Good job, Big Willy Style.